Hey, what's up? Thank you for tuning in to another video. Today we are going to be flying from Dayton, Ohio over to Columbus, Ohio. And today we're going to be fully VFR, so we're just going to take off. We're going to have some fun. We don't have any air traffic control on. I'm not going to be doing anything with autopilot or the GPS system or anything like that. We're just going to get out here and fly. We're going to have a little bit of fun and we'll head over to Columbus. So we're going to go ahead and get ready to take off here. Get our flaps taken care of. Get that parking brake off. And we'll just head out, man. We'll have a little bit of fun. We're still with the Honeycomb Alpha yoke. Still learning this yoke. So we're just having fun with it. Thank you for tuning in to the channel. Please like and subscribe, man. We got so much more footage and content coming from the Flight Simulator 2020 coming out and things like that. We got some good things on the way, so. And there we go, we're airborne. Right, so we are up. We're gonna fly probably around like 3,000 to 3,500 square feet. 3,000 to 3,500 feet. So we'll kind of be looking for that as we kind of climb out here. Give you a little quick view outside of the airport as we're climbing out. We'll view from the right side as we're leaving Dayton, headed on over to Columbus. I want to totally hand fly this, like I mentioned before. Just have a little bit of fun with it. Better kick that flap up a little bit. Get a little speed going to her. Beautiful day out today. Beautiful day out for flying. Little turn here. You want to be a little bit more to the east, kind of almost like a due east track. See the sun kind of come up over our eyes here relatively soon, but we are looking great. Little bit more speed into it and throttle up a little bit. Beautiful morning out here today, as you can see. Got a little bit of a haze. It's currently around 51 degrees. So it's just one of those kind of cool spring mornings. Nice outside, not too many clouds in the sky. We're gonna make a little bit more of a northerly turn here. See how fluid those motions are with the yoke. All right, so we're gonna trim down right around here. We'll stay right around this altitude for the duration of the flight. We'll get a little look outside as we are over, leaving out of Dayton, headed on over to Columbus. Get another view outside there as we're heading over. Nice. Looking good, everything's great, man. Just sit back and relax and enjoy flying. I really enjoy this, especially these times, man. You know, we're all kind of locked in with this coronavirus and that, so getting out here and having a little bit of fun and just flying is always a good deal. I might take and move the camera on my next, or move the joystick, or the Alpha Yoke Cam, as I call it, with the Alpha Flight Control Cam. I might end up moving that over to the right, because I think it would be kind of nice to be able to see outside on the left side here as we're kind of cruising. And having so much fun with this, figure, man, be a nice little thing just to do all a full. This will be like my first full flight with it. So we're sitting around. A little under 4,500, so this is cool. I don't mind that. Tracking wheel. Make a slight. Make a slight turn to our right here. Make sure we stay on track. As I say, such a beautiful morning. It's around 7:18 in the morning. Kind of start to see the sun come up there a little bit. Sitting at here. So we are currently just a little bit outside of Springfield, Ohio. We're tracking, we're heading over here to Columbus. So that's what we're doing. As you can see. City that you see right in front of us is Springfield, Ohio. So fly right over Springfield and into Columbus here. Just gonna cruise and enjoy it. Just have a little fun, sit back and relax, get comfy. We got a little bit of a flight ahead of us, but it'll be fun nonetheless. I'm starting to see the sun gonna come over the horizon a little bit there. Slight turn. such a beautiful morning for flying. I promise you, it really is. Everything feels really alive when you're flying, man. And I'm really looking forward to, you know, Microsoft Flight Simulator. It'd just be fun to kind of get my hands into something new. I played FSX for a very long time, and so it's nice to be able to have my hands on something like this. It's really amazing. But it'll be even more amazing to be able to play that flight simulator as long as everything works out. You know, I've been playing video games and doing simulators for a very long time. And we always know with releases, or you see things like, you know, with SimCity, or, you know, you have just certain things. You have all of these promises and different things that come out. And then oftentimes it comes out and the game is like completely different or not as good. And, you know, it's just one of those things you have to kind of deal with as a consumer. But I'm curious to really see how it all actually pans out. And I hope that Microsoft Flight Simulator can end up being as dope of a simulator as they're saying that it is. I'm really hoping. To give you a little quick outside view, we are flying over Springfield, Ohio right now. And we are heading into Columbus as we speak. If you see this, this highway over to our right here is I-70. So basically our flight path or plan, really, if we just follow the highway, you know, it'll take us right into Columbus. As you can, you see the highway, and then right behind us back here, the highway that's running to the north is State Route 4, just out in the Springfield, Ohio area. So basically all I gotta really do is just follow I-70 on into Columbus. That'll take me right where I need to go. So we'll just stay on point with everything we need to do. As you can see how these small little inputs really make a difference with this yoke. It's really amazing. Go, we're just cruising. You can see, still just kind of following I-70 over. We're gonna stay right around 5,000. We're just gonna cruise on in. You know, this is so immersive, and I actually actually play on a actually play on a 32 by 9 monitor, so it's like an ultra wide monitor, and that's why you'll see on the videos there's like this large black bar above and below the video. But it makes for widescreen, and you're really able to just see a lot more, which I think is good. I know it makes the video a little bit smaller on the YouTube end of things, but for me, I like it. Just following I-70 on down. That's kind of our marker, you know. That's how I know I'm on point. That's how I can kind of navigate where I'm going. Just gonna cruise and just have a little bit of fun on today. So just enjoy the flight. Give you a little view of outside, see what down to our right down there. You can see it's the State Route 270. I'm sorry, State Route 70, I-70. Those cars are. We're heading on into Columbus this morning. There we are. Faintly in the distance, I can start seeing Columbus. Come back in the cockpit here. Looking really well. We're gonna actually land on runway 28 left once we get into Columbus. We're doing this very, very slow descent right now. Just very, like, ever so slightly. I'm just kind of coming down a bit. Another quick view outside this morning. What I'm gonna do is just make straight in for the airport. So we're gonna do actually, we're gonna try to land on runway 10 right. So we're gonna get set up for that. Start shaving off just a little bit more speed so we can start descending a little bit. I do have eyes on the field from where I am right now. So we're gonna get lined up. Once we get lined up, we'll have probably about a 10-mile final, and then we'll be able to try to put her on the ground. So go ahead and cut some more speed just so we keep our descent that we have going here. Starting to see the airport. Drop a little bit more speed and continue our descent on down. See it there, just off in our distance. Off in the distance, I'm starting to see the Dublin area and Hilliard. Right. We're pretty much lined up from right there, so we'll just kind of maintain a visual here. See downtown Columbus off to our right here in just a little bit. Like the descent that we're on, I'm going to keep it for now. It is slow, but it's good. I think we're right on point with what we need. So airport that you can see off here to our left is Ohio State University Airport, and the one right in front of us is John Glenn International, and that's where we're heading. Put this baby on down. Right now, I'm just kind of monitoring our altitude and our slow descent that we've been doing here for a while. We're coming down nice. I like where we are. I like how we're looking. So once we kind of get inside that 270 corridor here, we'll really start shaving back some speed and start start a little bit more of a descent on down to the runway. Maintaining a visual right now. Starting to see downtown Columbus right there. Just off to our right. Currently at about 3,500 feet, which is nice. We'll just keep on coming down. I like our descent path. I like what we're doing here. Now we're starting to get around that 270 corridor, as you can see down here. Coming right over the Hilliard, Upper Arlington area. Headed down to the airport. Why drive when you can just fly, right? So we are just coming over. We're getting into the Upper Arlington area of Columbus. We will go ahead and cut a little bit more power. Shaving off a little more speed. Columbus just off to our right, downtown. currently kind of coming through Grandview Heights area, headed on down. Start cutting some power here. Put in a little bit of flaps here. Stable, got a little bit of wind kicking here. Okay, get down a little bit. Okay. We are looking real good on landing. Beautiful landing. Love it. Love it. What a great, great flight. Great landing. Wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Thank you so much for tuning in to another flight here on the channel. Don't hesitate to run that replay back. That was an amazing landing.